Morning children, welcome to science 2 class. Students, take one pen, pencil, notebook and the textbook. Those who don't have hard copy, kindly download the e-textbook. Girls, we have studied classification of living organisms in earlier standards. We know that they are classified on the basis of their characters such as nucleus, mode of nutrition, cell wall, etc. The criteria used to classify plants are presence of organs, flowers, seeds, conducting tissues, etc. Students, as a revision, one flowchart is given in your textbook on page 61. Draw it in your notebook and complete it. There are about 7 million species of different animals on Earth. And we see a great diversity among them. Huge animals like elephants, tiny like ants. Some animals need microscope to observe them. Snakes have scales, birds have feathers, fish live in water, earthworms under the soil. It is impossible to study and remember each and every animal, but we notice similarities and differences in animals. Therefore, our scientists tried different methods to classify the animals. Let us look at the history of animal classification. The great philosopher Aristotle proposed the artificial method. He took into account the criteria like body size, habits and habitats. Same method was used by Theocritus, Pliny, etc. Further, due to advances in science, the references were changed and natural system of classification based on body organization, types of cells, chromosomes was proposed. Later, scientists tried the systems based on evolution and three-domain system. Let us know how this classification is useful and beneficial. The study of vast variety of animals is possible. Study of few representative animals gives idea about the animals belonging to same group, helps to understand the process of animal evolution, relation of animals with each other, various adaptations by animals, identification of animals became easy. Girls, write and learn the benefits of classification in your notebook. Depending upon the presence or absence of the notochord, animal kingdom is divided into two groups, non-chordates and chordates. You must be wondering what is a notochord. It's a long, flexible, rod-like structure present on dorsal, that is back or upper side of animal body. In vertebrates, it develops into vertebrate column. Let us understand the characters of chordates and non-chordates. First, non-chordates. Non-chordates are less evolved animals. They don't have notochord. Pharyngeal gill slits are absent. Nerve cord, if it is present, it is double and solid. Heart, if it is present, it is on dorsal side. Let us move to characteristics of chordates. Chordates are more evolved animals. They possess notochord. Pharyngeal gill slits or lungs are present for respiration. Nerve cord is on dorsal side. It is single and hollow. Heart is on ventral side. Girls, I hope it is clear to you. Write the differences between chordates and non-chordates in your notebook and learn it. Let us learn about the classification in more detail. Non-chordates are divided into 10 phyla: Protozoa, Porifera, Coelenterata or Cnidaria, Platyhelminthes, Aeschylomyces, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata and Hemichordata. All chordates are grouped in a single phylum, that is Chordata, which is further divided into three subphyla: Urochordata, Cephalochordata and Vertebrata. Subphylum Vertebrata is further divided into six classes: Cyclostomata, Pisces, Amphibia, Reptilia, Aves and Mammalia. Girls, I hope you followed this. Draw this flow chart in your notebook and learn it. Nowadays, a new five kingdom system proposed by Robert Whittaker is followed. This system is based upon criteria like body organization, body symmetry, body cavity, germinal layers, segmentation, etc. Let us study this in brief. First criteria for new system of classification is grades of organization. The grades of organization means the way an organism has different body formation. Unicellular organisms like amoeba, paramecium are included in protoplasmic grid. Phylum Porifera have only cells. Tissues are not formed in their body, which is called cellular grid organization. In case of phylum Cnidaria, cells come together to form tissues. They show cell tissue grid organization. Tissues are organized to form some organs. This is tissue organ grid organization. For example, Platyhelminthes. All other higher animals show organ system grid organization. In this case, different organs are joined together to form specific functions. For example, crab, frog, human, etc. The second criteria is body symmetry. The symmetry can be understood by taking an imaginary cut through the animal body. Based on symmetry, there can be three types. In asymmetric animals, there is no symmetry in any plane. For example, amoeba. The imaginary cut passing through central axis, but any plane of body, gives more than one equal house. These animals show radial symmetry. For example, starfish. In bilateral symmetry, we get two equal halves through one imaginary axis. For example, insects, fish, dog, human, etc. Third criteria for new system is germ layers. Germ layers are formed during initial period of any multicellular animal, and those layers give rise to new tissues. Primitive animals are diploblastic, that is, they have only two layers, ectoderm and endoderm. For example, phylum Cnidaria. The higher animals are triploblastic. They have three layers, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. The next criteria is body segmentation. The body of these animals is divided into small similar units called segments. For example, earthworm from phylum Annelida. Last criteria used in new system is body cavity. The cavity between the body wall and internal organs is called the body cavity or coelom. The animals having true body cavity are called eucoelomate. Phylum Annelida onwards are eucoelomate. Body cavity is absent in phyla Porifera, Cnidaria and Platyhelminthes. They are called acoelomate. In some animals, coelom is not formed from mesoderm or gut, but it is formed from other tissues. They are called pseudocoelomates. For example, Escalmentis. Gulls. In this way, all the animals can be classified using these five criteria. I hope it is clear to you. Read the lesson carefully. See you in next class. Thank you. Take care.